Welcome to Lab 4 for Physical Geography. In this lab, we will be looking at evidence for plate tectonics and calculating the movement of tectonic plates over time. As we have discussed in lecture, major pieces of evidence for the theory of plate tectonics are earthquakes, volcanoes, and the reversal of the Earth's magnetic field as recorded in the rocks of the ocean floor. In this lab, you will be using the Jules Verne Voyager website to look at pieces of evidence. I am going to give you some tips for using the Jules Verne Voyager site, but first let's look a little more closely at what is going on with these pretty rainbow-colored maps that show seafloor age. Scientists have various lines of evidence that the geomagnetic field of our Earth has reversed polarity repeatedly through the Earth's history. This means that a magnetic compass that now points north would point south. The magnetic field reverses on average every 500,000 years, but reversals have happened as frequently as 100,000 years or as long as 1 million years. The last geomagnetic reversal was approximately 780,000 years ago. When lava is extruded at spreading centers in the ocean floor, the iron in the rocks fixes to the current polarity of the Earth's magnetic field. So in this way, we have a record of magnetic reversals captured in the ocean floor. Also, we use this pattern of alternating polarity to calculate seafloor age. Pretty cool, huh? Okay, next I'm going to show you how to navigate the Jules Verne Voyager website. So there is a link to the Jules Verne Voyager website from the lab handout. Now what we have here is an interactive web map. You can change the data shown on the map and zoom in and out of it. The first thing you are asked to do is look at earthquakes. To display the earthquakes, select a gray topography background so that the earthquakes show up better on them, and then choose the earthquakes. Click on the Make Changes button. Notice that your legend is a pop-up window, so it will either disappear or go behind your main window, so you may need to retrieve it. If you have a pop-up blocker on your computer, you may need to disable the pop-up blocker in order to view the legend. Now, looking at the map, what we see is that the green dots are the shallowest earthquakes, and the red and the pink dots are the deepest earthquakes. To change the map for the next question, just select the new overlay, Ocean Floor Age, and click on Make Changes. Now let's take a look at the last question in the lab, which asks you to use information from questions 9 through 11 to calculate how long it will take for San Francisco and Los Angeles to meet along the San Andreas Fault. Of course, this is a very rough estimate, but if you do the math right, you will come up with an answer that is within a quarter of a million years of the current estimates of scientists in the field. Okay, so we start with San Francisco and LA, which are on opposite sides of the San Andreas Fault. The San Andreas Fault is a right lateral strike slip fault, which means that San Francisco is moving south while LA is moving north along the fault. First, take the speed of San Francisco and Los Angeles from numbers 9 and 10. Add these up. Since we are assuming that the motion is along the fault, this gives you total speed in millimeters per year. Next, for number 11, use your atlas and a ruler to find the distance in miles between the two cities. Now, in order to work with the speed and the distance, we need to have them in the same distance units. So use the conversion factors provided in the lab to convert miles to millimeters. This way, we are comparing like units. Okay, we're nearly there. We next need to take the distance and divide it by the speed. The distance units cancel out, leaving only years, which moves the denominator up to the numerator, giving us the number of years until the two cities meet. This is a good point to do a reality check, something that you should do whenever you make a big calculation. Does your result make sense? Your answer should be several million years. If you got an answer of, say, 3 years, think about it. Does this make real-world sense? Probably not. So you likely made a math mistake somewhere, and you should go back and check your work. That's about it for this lab. Make sure that you pay attention to significant figures on the lab. For each question, I tell you what precision to round your answers to. Also, make sure to show all your work on your calculations. If you have questions, send me a private message or post in the class message center. Happy trails!